How'd you like to have a beer with the Steelers? Well, you can, with these great new cans from Iron City. The 1975 Super Bowl champion Steeler cans, with Iron City beer on the inside, and the whole 1975 Super Bowl champion Steeler team on the outside. These are really super cans. But then, you're really super fans. So have a beer with the Steelers.
Channel 4, your action news station.
Regularly scheduled programs will not be seen tonight so that we may bring you the college all-star football game.
From Soldier Field in Chicago, Illinois, it's the college all-stars versus the National Football League champion Pittsburgh Steelers in the 42nd college all-star football game. This ABC sports exclusive brought to you by Mutual of New York. Insurance for life, health, and retirement, individual or group, money for the future. By Sears Tire and Auto Centers, home of the diehard battery, and the Sears Road Handler steel-belted radial tire. By Pabst Blue Ribbon Beer, since 1844, the quality has always come through. And by Schick Super 2, the twin-blade cartridge with Teflon that makes closeness comfortable. Well, after a year off, the traditional lid lifter for the football season is back in good health. The college all-stars against the NFL champions being played as usual in Chicago. And opening at quarterback for the college all-stars, the number one pick of them all, Steve Bartkowski of California, now the property of the Atlanta Falcons. Another quarterback you'll see tonight, Steve Joachim of Temple, now property of the Baltimore Colts, the total offense leader a year ago in college football. Well, Messrs. Bartkowski and Joachim and the rest of the college all-stars will have some pressure tonight. From the steel curtain, number 68, Elsie Greenwood, 75, Joe Green, 63, Ernie Holmes, and 78, Dwight White. Remember, in the Super Bowl, these people held the Minnesota Vikings to only 17 yards on the ground. Number 32, one of those rare big backs that can fly, Franco Harris, gained over 1,000 yards a year ago and was the MVP in the Super Bowl. The Steeler quarterback, Terry Bradshaw, checks in at a sleek 201 pounds for 1975, brimming with the confidence that comes from winning it all. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the defensive team for the NFL champion Pittsburgh Steelers. At left end, number 68, Elsie Greenwood. At left tackle, number 75, Mean Joe Green. At right tackle, number 63, Ernie Holmes. At right end, number 78, Dwight White. The left linebacker, number 59, Jack Hamm. The middle linebacker, number 58, Jack Lambert. The right linebacker, number 34, Andy Russell. The left cornerback, number 24, J.T. Thomas. The right cornerback, number 47, Mel Blunt. At safety, number 23, Mike Wagner. And the free safety, number 27, Glenn Edwards. And the head coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers, Chuck Noll. And now, introducing the offensive team for the college all-stars. At wide receiver, number 84, from Harvard, drafted by the Cincinnati Bengals, Pat McAnally. At left tackle, number 71, from Miami, drafted by the Los Angeles Rams, Dennis Hara. Left guard, number 68, from North Carolina, drafted by the Baltimore Colts, Ken Huff. At center, number 50, from Oklahoma, drafted by the Dallas Cowboys, Kyle Davis. Right guard, number 65 from South Dakota State, drafted by the Detroit Lions, Lynn Bodine. The right tackle, number 72 from Ohio State, drafted by the New Orleans Saints, Kurt Schumacher. The tight end, number 81 from Oregon, drafted by the New England Patriots, Russ Francis. At wide receiver, number 46 from Kansas, drafted by the Houston Oilers, Emmett Edwards. At quarterback, number 10 from California, drafted by the Atlanta Falcons, Steve Bartkowski. At running back, number 34 from Jackson State, drafted by the Chicago Bears, Walter Payton. And at running back, number 23 from Arkansas State, drafted by the Miami Dolphins, Stan Winfrey. And the head coach of the College All-Stars, John McKay of the University of Southern California. The pros have won it 29 times. The collegians have won 9. There have been 2 ties. We'll see what happens tonight here in Chicago. McAnally, 84 from Harvard. 6'6 is in at the wide receiver position left side. As Bartkowski has time, hums it. He's got McAnally wide open. Could possibly nullify a 28-yard touchdown pass run play. Hang on. It's against Pittsburgh, the All-Stars lead.
Pittsburgh offside on the play. Beautiful pass protection. There's McAnally. It's just simply a crossing pattern. You can see the defensive secondary. Thomas coming across, Wagner coming across, getting against the grain motion, and when Bartkowski hit him full speed, he was able to take it into the end zone.
And McAnally is carried from the field by 2 of his teammates. Mickey Meyer is in for the extra point try. The hold is clean, the kick is sharp. 79 yards, 4 plays, 2 minutes 24 seconds of possession, and the College All-Stars have jumped into the lead by a score of 7-0 on a hot, muggy night in Chicago.
The best way for a marine biologist to learn about the great white shark isn't from books. He's got to go down and take a look for himself. The best way to learn about quality in beer is to taste it for yourself. Take the Pabst Challenge. Taste and compare the quality and flavor of Pabst Blue Ribbon with any other premium beer. See why in Milwaukee, beer capital of the world, it's number one. Pabst. Since 1844, the quality has always come through.
Monday night game against the New Orleans Saints. That's when he really began to put it all together last year.
Virgil Livers, 24, out of Western Kentucky, and Charles Phillips, number 49, out of Southern Cal, dropping back under the front as Bobby Walden is in for Pittsburgh. And another dandy by the old pro. Oh, it's a beauty. All the way back to the 13-yard line, it's Livers. He's got some blocks. He's got some daylight. He's got some room. He cuts back. He may go all the way. I don't see any penalty flags. It is 87 yards for a touchdown.
And that is some beautiful blocking and some great, great running.
A 56-yard punt and 87-yard return. The big, big block that sprung him loose was thrown by Robert Blasio, the 230-pounder from Jackson State.
And they're going crazy in this ballpark because that young man joins the Chicago Bears.
Moral of the story, do not outkick your coverage.
That's a terrible thing to say after a man just kicked a 56-yarder.
I know, but let's take a look at it again. Anytime you get a good back, a full head of steam up the field, and particularly with this pro rule, when only the 2 outside men can go with the snap of the ball, there's nobody there. He's made 15 yards before he gets any kind of action, and with that full head of steam up the field, beautiful block right there, opened it up for him, and boy, did he turn it on here.
All right, Steve Mickenmeyer in for the extra point try out of the hole of Joachim, and it is good. And at 3:26 to go in the first half, we're having some fun in Chicago as the College All-Stars have come back to lead the Steelers 14-7.
There it goes again. Urshel Ivers, Western Kentucky. And the cutback is brilliant. Once again, you'll see the key block thrown by Brazil out of Jackson State, the young man we discussed earlier, so raved about by Willie Davis of the All-Stars coaching staff, one of the all-time great defensive ends in the NFL. It's home free here for Urshel Ivers and for the Chicago Bears fans who anticipate the arrival of Walter Payton and Ivers this year, a moment of fandom ecstasy.
And tomorrow, pro football over most of these ABC stations as ABC's Wide World of Sports goes to 3 hours for exclusive coverage of the Pro Football Hall of Fame game live from Canton, Ohio, the Cincinnati Bengals and the Washington Redskins.
What you're looking at now is really a preview of the game you'll be seeing tomorrow at 4 o'clock Eastern Time over most of these ABC stations. The Pro Football Hall of Fame, the Washington Redskins, number 42, Charlie Taylor, against the Cincinnati Bengals. The Bengals beat the Redskins a year ago. George Allen remembers it vividly. Said the Bengals had the best special teams in the league.
Rocky Blyer is back in at a setback position with Joe Gillum now at quarterback, number 17. He started the season at quarterback for them a year ago. Here's the handoff now to Reggie Harrison, 46, the 220-pounder. Randy White hits him as he moves the football from the 42 down to the 34.
The 133 yards that the Stars have gained were picked up almost entirely in the first quarter. So since that time and in the air, since that time, the Steeler defense has been superb. The long punt return, 87 yards by Livers, being the second touchdown. The Steelers have really dominated play since about the first 8 or 10 minutes.
Defense in front now for the All-Stars, spanning Otha Bradley, 75, Randy White, and Robert Brazil.
3:44.
On second down, 2. From the 34, it's Harrison, first down, breaks the 30, goes to the 28.
Suddenly, under Jefferson Street, Joe Gillum, the Steelers are moving.
Gonna test a little metal right here.
Oh, yes.
Gillum to throw. Has a man. Fire. Touchdown.
Well, Rocky Blyer made a difference when Noel put him back in.
Little crossing pattern. They were in a man-to-man defense. Blyer on the cross was wide open.
Now the Steelers need the extra point from Roy Girella to tie at 14. With 10 minutes and 19 seconds to play in the ball game. Steelers taking it 42 yards, 8 plays, 4 minutes, 23 seconds. The kick is good. And now let's see what happens over the next 10 minutes and 19 seconds as we once again are all even at 14. Gillum back to throw. Delivers to Lewis.
There he goes.
Touchdown. The Steelers have the lead for the first time tonight. Lewis is the 8th different Steeler to catch a football.
Hard enough to pick them up when you're going against the grain, but on a wet track like this one, you slide as you try to change direction, and the All-Star secondary had no chance.
Girella for the kick. As we see the replay, and it's raining again now in Chicago. And the kick is good. And so we have 4 minutes and 16 seconds to play. The Steelers have the lead over the All-Stars for the first time, 21-14. I haven't seen any lightning or heard any thunder, but the rain is coming down quite steadily now.